Hello everybody, this is Mr. Birajdar Bala Saheb, Assistant Professor, Department of Humanities and Sciences, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. In this video lecture, we will discuss Applications to Electrical Circuit, Part 2. Learning Outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to solve problems of RL and RC series electrical circuits with initial condition. In previous video lecture, we discussed how to form a differential equation of RL and RC circuit along with the some examples. Now in this video session, we will illustrate more examples on RL and RC circuits. Let us pause the video for a while and write the answer to the question. Question is, write the differential equation of RC series circuit. Come back. I hope you have written answer to this question. Here I will going to explain the solution. Question is, write the differential equation of RC circuit. RC circuit means a circuit containing resistance and capacitance in series with electromotive force E of T. As we know that voltage drop across resistance is R into dQ by dt, and voltage drop across capacitance is Q by C. And by using Kirchhoff's voltage law, sum of voltage drop across R and C is equal to electromotive force applied to the circuit. Therefore, R into dQ by dt plus Q by C is equal to E of t, where E of t is a voltage source called as electromotive force. So this is the required differential equation of RC circuit. Now let us consider the example. Example 1. An electromotive force of 200 into e raised to minus 5 t volt is connected in series with 20 ohm resistance, 0.01 farad capacitance. Find the charge and current at a time t if there is no charge initially. Solution. By reading this problem, we come to know that given resistance R equal to 20 ohm, capacitance C equal to 0.01 farad, and electromotive force EMF, which is denoted by E of t, equal to 200 into e raised to minus 5 t volt. And initially there is no charge, means Q equal to 0 at t equal to 0. By knowing this problem, we come to know that it is a RC circuit. So that the differential equation of RC circuit is R into dQ by dt plus Q by C equal to E of t. Now in this, substitute the value of R, C and E of t. Therefore, R is 20 ohm, therefore 20 into dQ by dt plus Q upon C is 0.01 farad. So Q upon 0.01 is equal to value of E of t is 200 into e raised to minus 5 t. Now dividing 20 on both the side, we get dQ by dt plus Q upon 20 into 0.01 is equal to 200 into e raised to minus 5 t upon 20. Now after simplification, we get dQ by dt plus 5 Q is equal to 10 into e raised to minus 5 t. Denote this equation by 1. It is the differential equation of given circuit. This differential equation is belongs to first order, first degree linear differential equation with Q as a dependent variable and T independent variable. When we compare this differential equation with a general linear differential equation dy by dx plus py equal to Q, we get value of capital P is equal to 5 and value of capital Q is 10 into e raised to minus 5 t. And these are the either function of T or constant. Now the solution of differential equation 1 we have to find out. First of all, we find its integrating factor if equal to e to power integration of p dt, which is equal to e to power integration of p is 5 into dt is equal to e to power 5 as it is and integration of dt is t. Therefore, integrating factor of differential equation 1 is e raised to 5 t. Now general solution of differential equation 1 is given by Q into IF is equal to integration of if into q into dt plus k. Now substitute the value of integrating factor and value of capital Q. We get q into e raised to 5t is equal to integration of e raised to 5t into value of q is 10 into e raised to minus 5t dt plus k. Therefore, q into e raised to 5t is equal to, now 10 constant you can take outside, into integration of e raised to 5t into e raised to minus 5t becomes e raised to 0 dt plus constant k. Therefore, q into e raised to 5t is equal to 10 into integration of dt is t and plus constant k. Now, dividing e raised to 5t on both the side, we get charge q equal to 10 t plus k upon e raised to 5t, that is q equal to 10 t into e raised to minus 5t plus k into e raised to minus 5t. Denote this equation by 2. Now we have to find value of constant k using initial condition. We are given q is equal to 0 at t equal to 0. Put it in equation second. Therefore, 0 is equal to 0 plus k into e raised to 0. But e raised to 0 is 1, so that k equal to 0. Now substitute this value of k in equation 2. We get charge q equal to 10 into t into e raised to minus 5t coulomb. This is the charge at any time t. Now to find the current I, we have to differentiate this charge q with respect to t. We get dq by dt equal to, now in the right hand side 10 as it is, and the differentiation of t into e raised to minus 5t by product rule, keeping t as it is, and derivative of e raised to minus 5t is minus 5 into e raised to minus 5t plus keeping e raised to minus 5t as it is, and derivative of t is 1, bracket close, which is equal to 10 as it is. Now taking e raised to minus 5t is common outside, in bracket we get minus 5t plus 1, bracket close, into e raised to minus 5t. But I is equal to dq by dt, therefore I is equal to 10 in bracket minus 5t plus 1, bracket close, into e to power minus 5t ampere. This is the required current at any time t flowing in the circuit. Now consider example 2. A condenser of capacity C is charged through resistance R by steady voltage V. Prove that if Q equal to 0 at T equal to 0, the charge is Q equal to C into V in bracket 1 minus e to power minus T upon RC, bracket close. Solution. The given circuit is RC circuit, so that its differential equation is R into dq by dt plus q by c equal to e of t. But we are given steady voltage V as a electromotive force e of t. Therefore, R into dq by dt plus q by c equal to V. Dividing R on both the side, we get dq by dt plus q upon R into c equal to V upon R. So this is the differential equation of given circuit, and it is the differential equation of first order and first degree, belongs to linear differential equation type. Dy by dx plus py is equal to q. Here p means 1 upon r into c, and capital Q means V upon R. Now we can find the solution of this differential equation. For that, first of all, we find its integrating factor by formula. If equal to e to power integration of p with respect to t, which is equal to e to power integration of value of p is 1 upon r into c into dt, which is equal to e to power 1 upon r into c constant as it is, and integration of dt is t. Therefore, integrating factor is equal to e to power t upon r into c. Now, general solution of this differential equation is q into integrating factor is equal to integration of integrating factor into q into dt plus constant of integration k. Now substitute the value of integrating factor and value of capital Q. We get Q into e to power t upon r into c is equal to integration of e to power t upon r into c into value of capital Q is V by R dt plus k. Therefore, Q into e raised to t upon r into c is equal to, now in right side V upon R is constant taken outside the integration, and integration of e raised to t upon r into c is e to power t upon r into c whole divided by 1 upon r into c plus constant k. Therefore, Q into e raised to t upon r into c is equal to, in right side in denominator r, r gets cancelled and c goes to numerator, so that V into c into e to power t upon r into c plus constant k. Now dividing e raised to t upon r into c on both this side, we get Q equal to V into c into e to power t upon r into c plus k whole divided by e to power t upon r into c. Therefore, Q equal to V into c plus k into e raised to minus t upon r into c. Denote this equation by 2. Now we have to find value of constant k using U1 initial condition. That is, Q equal to 0 at t equal to 0. This is given. Put these two values in equation 2. We get 0 equal to V into c plus k into e raised to 0. But e raised to 0 is 1. So that k equal to minus V into c. Substitute this value of k in equation 2. Therefore, charge Q equal to V into c as it is plus value of k is minus V into c into e raised to minus t by r into c. Therefore, Q is equal to, now taking V into c common in the right hand side, we get V into c in bracket 1 minus e raised to minus t upon r into c. So this is the required charge at any time t we have to prove. Hence the proof. To prepare this video lecture, I refer this book as a references. Thank you.